Hello children, in this video we will get to know how we can create and edit relationships between tables in OpenOffice base. So let us do it practically. Here I have opened OpenOffice base. We have these tables here. So you can create a relationship between any two tables by selecting tool tab and then relationship option. As I have already selected these two, otherwise you will get a dialog box of add table here. From this dialog box, you can add the desired table by clicking on the add button, right? So I have already selected student data and student table here. Click on close. Then simply what you have to do, drag the primary key from one table and drop it on the key column of another table, right? So I'm from student data table, I'm dragging student ID to the roll number. So here you can see 1 and 1 is written. That means one-to-one relationship has been established. Click on save button. Now the relationship has been saved and then close. Now the relationship has been established between student data table and student table, right? Now the term comes referential integrity. What is referential integrity? Referential integrity is used to maintain accuracy and consistency of data in a relationship, right? Means referential integrity is a term, right, which is a constraint, or you can say is a constraint which is used to create relationship between two tables. Right, in base, data can be linked between two or more tables with the help of primary key and foreign key constraint. In base, two tables can be linked by using primary key and foreign key constraint. As just we have established the relationship, abhi humne do tables ka relationship banaya. ठीक है, तो क्या क्या हुआ इस रिलेशनशिप बनाने से? व्हाट वी हैव डन, वी हैव एस्टेब्लिश्ड द रेफरेंशियल इंटीग्रिटी बिटवीन दीज टू टेबल्स, राइट? नाउ दीज टू टेबल्स आर रिलेटेड टू ईच अदर. नाउ व्हाट इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ रेफरेंशियल इंटीग्रिटी? रेफरेंशियल इंटीग्रिटी हैज टू अवॉइड adding records to a related table if there is no associated record available in the primary key table, right? So what does it mean? Iska meaning ye hai, agar primary table mein record hai, but if you want to add some other record in the related table, aap foreign key table mein koi dusra record add karna chahte ho, to wo usko avoid karega, nahi lega. Foreign key table mein wahi records add honge jo primary key table ke andar present hai, right? Let us do it practically. Now I have established relation between student data table. This is the student data table, right? Having 4 records: student ID, address, and father name. Having student ID 1, 2, 3, 4, and then student table, right? Roll numbers, student name, and marks, right? So here I have student ID 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, and same with the student table, I have roll number 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So if I'll try to add roll number 5, okay, Meena 90, when I'll go to the next record, you can see it is showing error. इंटीग्रिटी कंस्ट्रेंट वायलेशन, इसका मीनिंग क्या है? ये आप रेफरेंशियल इंटीग्रिटी के अगेंस्ट जा रहे हो. नाउ दीज टू टेबल्स आर कनेक्टेड, दे आर लिंक्ड, सो दे शुड हैव द डेटा व्हिच इज प्रेजेंट इन द प्राइमरी की. ओनली दैट डेटा शुड बी अवेलेबल इन द फॉरेन की. अब प्राइमरी की में कोई भी रिकॉर्ड नंबर 5 नहीं है, right? So we cannot insert record 5 here. So what you will do? You will delete this, right? I can use. Okay, so close this one. Yes. Again, I cannot insert this record because this is not present in the primary key. Fine. Next, we have changing values. First was the adding records to a related table if there is no associated record available in the primary key table. That we have done, right? That we have done. Next, changing values in a primary if any dependent records are present in associated table. What does it mean? It means we cannot change any value in the primary key table if the same record is present in the foreign key table or in the associated table. Hum koi bhi record change nahi kar sakte primary key ka agar same record present hai foreign key table mein. Let us do it. Okay, close. No. This is our primary key table. So I want to change this from 3 to 5. Now you can see. Again, the error is coming. Why? Because I am changing the record of primary key table. And this is not present in the foreign key table. It is not present in the related table, right? So we cannot change record. Why? Because record 3 was present. Student ID 3 was related to the roll number 3. Okay, so we cannot change this. Again, we have to save this and then close. Now next. Okay, deleting records from a primary key table if there are any matching related records available in associated table. Neither we can change the record nor we can delete the record. Same, if I try to change the record here, you can see if I try to change the record, delete the record in the primary key table, delete rows. Yes, it is showing me error. I cannot delete this. Why? Because this is related to the foreign key table, right? So I cannot delete any record in this. This is because of referential integrity. Referential integrity means now these two tables are related to each other. Student data is the primary table because it contains the primary key, and student table is the foreign table because it contains the foreign key, right? So we, because of the referential integrity constraint. Referential integrity constraint is formed by creating relationship between two tables, right? Primary key table and foreign key table, right? Okay. Next. So what is the use of this relationship, establishing relationship between the table? Save time as there is no need to enter the same data in separate tables. Okay, both the tables are linked. So there is no need to enter the data again and again. Second, reduce data entry errors. We cannot enter the duplicate data and we cannot do the data entry errors as we have just seen. Summarize data from related tables. And we get the summary of the data, okay, from the related tables, right? Next, there are three types of relationships which can be created in the tables: one-to-one, one-to-many, or many-to-one, and many-to-many, right? So we have three types of relationship: one-to-one. In this relationship, both the tables must have primary key columns. In one-to-one, both the tables which we are linking, which we are connecting, should have the primary key columns, right? In one-to-many relationship, one of the table must have primary key column. This is the requirement that in one to many relationship, one table should have the primary key column, and it can be connected to the many records of the another table, right? Okay. In many to many relationship, no table has the primary key, and any record of one table can be connected to the any record of another table. Okay, so in one-to-one relationship, both the tables should have primary key columns, and there will be the connection between the primary keys of both the columns, right? In one-to-many relationship, one table should have the primary key and another table, there is no compulsion that another table should have the primary key, and primary key of one table can be connected to any key or any column of the related table. In many-to-many relationship, no table has primary key, and any one column of one table can be connected to the any one column or any one field of the another table. Okay, we can also remove the relationship among the tables, right? The relationship applied on the tables can be removed also with the help of delete option. So let us do it practically, how you can delete the relationship. Okay, so again click on the tools and then relationship. This is the relationship which is already created. Click here, right click here, and then delete. Now the relationship has been deleted. If you want to save this and then close. Okay, so this is all about how you can establish the relationship among the between the tables, and how you can delete the relationship. Okay, thank you. One more thing here I want to tell you, how you can sort the data in a table. Simply I'm clicking on one table. This is the table, let us suppose this is the table. Click on the column that you want to sort. Okay, in the toolbar the sort option is given, A to Z. That means short ascending, and Z to A, that means short descending. So you can click on any of the option. So you can see here, it has been shorted in ascending order. Now, if you want to short it in a descending order, you can click on this button, short descending. So in this way, you can short the columns you can short the data in a table, right? Okay, thank you.